Hi, and welcome back to myexcelonline.com. Today, we are going to go over how to add a signature in Microsoft Outlook. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description. So if I'm in Outlook and I click New Email, look down here. I already have my name entered, my phone number, and my email address. I'm not going to type this every single time I send an email, but it's really, really helpful to have everyone that I'm sending an email to already know the basic information, like my phone number, my email address, maybe my hours of operation, or maybe my website, or maybe a logo as well. So we're going to go over those things today. But just know right now, this area right here is called a signature. So I'm going to cancel out of this email and I'm going to show you two different places where you can edit that signature. The first one is if I go to File, Options, and if I click Mail, if you look over in this section right here where it says Create or Modify Signatures for Messages, and I click this button that says Signatures, then you can see this is all the information that was on the new email that I just created. But let's make this look a lot nicer. I'm going to put my last initial and I'm going to put my company, and some people like to put their job title here. So I'll just say I'm a YouTuber, and then there's a phone number and there's my email address. This to me is the standard information. There's more that you can put in here. Like I would like to put www.myexcelonline.com in here as well. And one more thing I would like to put in here to make this look really nice is if I go over here, I can insert a logo that can be part of my signature. Now let's make this look a little nicer. What if I center all of this? And what if I bold maybe my first name? Maybe I would like the default font here to be something else. I can change that to, let's say, Arial Black. I can also highlight my title and italicize that. And you can also underline, you can change the size of the font, whatever it is that you would like to do here for your preference. Another thing I would like to show you is this option up here. This signature is associated with this email account. Now, if I were to have more than one email account in here, I could actually have a signature for other email accounts too. So say I have a personal email account and I have a work email account, I can create two different signatures and still use Outlook. But for now, this is just going to go with my email that I'm using right now in Outlook. And these two questions, new messages or replies forwards, I definitely want to use this signature on a new message to someone, but maybe I don't want this much information when I'm just replying to someone else with an email that I've already received, because they've already gotten most of my information on my original email. So I'm going to save this one, and then I'm going to create a new signature, and this one is going to be a reply signature. And I'm going to say okay, and this one, I will just put my name and www.myexcelonline.com and maybe a phone number. And for that, I'm going to change this over here. And for new messages, I'm going to make that be my Sharon signature. And for the replies or forwards, I'm going to make that be my reply signature. So I'm going to save this. For my new emails, I'm going to have this. And for any emails that I reply to other messages, I'm going to have this. So I'm going to say okay, and I'm going to say okay in here again. Now, if you don't remember where that setting is, I want to show you a really useful tool that can help you find almost anything you learn online really quickly. So if I go up here to search and I just start typing signature, you can see any setting that matches what I'm typing up here. So I'm going to click on signature and go over here with this arrow to signatures. And you can see that I can get right back to those two signatures that I just created. So that's a really quick shortcut on how to get back to that. So let's create a new email. So I'm going to send this to myself. And when I check my inbox, you can see that that message is in there. And look at the signature that's on there. It is the signature for a new message. So if I hit reply and I send this back to myself, look at the signature that's there now. It's not my big long signature. It's only my small signature. So that's the difference between the two signature settings for reply and for new messages. If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos. Now, this isn't the only way to use Outlook. Don't forget, you can also go to Outlook.com. And if you're on Outlook.com, you can go up here to Settings. And this is very similar to what I just showed you on What Settings. So let's type in Signature right here. And there's this option for Email Signature. And I can also create a signature. So I'm going to go in here and type in my name again. And I'm going to retype all of my information. Again, I can insert a picture. And I'm going to insert my logo. And this one's a little bit bigger, so I'm going to just drag it down. And if I wanted to, I could highlight all of that. And I could center that as well. I can still bold. And I can change the color of my text. And I can do whatever other formatting that I would like. And then down here, I want to make sure that I use this new signature for new messages. And when I'm done with that, I can hit save and close out of this window. Now, if I go to a new message, you can see that my signature is automatically added here as well. So hopefully this shows you how you can add a signature to either Outlook Online or the desktop version of Microsoft Outlook that you have on your PC. If you have any questions on this, please leave it below in the comments section. I hope you learned something new today and look forward to seeing you again next time. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.